Hey everybody, Hunter for Hire here, and I've taken Blood Wolf's map and edited it for play, and made a few changes. A couple things, we got the rules here. We have four missions now. To bug the ambassador, you gotta punch him. You gotta carry the book in your hand, so let me show you that one. So I've taken the liberty of putting the books actually in the bookcase. So you just gotta stand on the blue, right click. Take your blue to the one. Oh, you better have it. And NPCs can do this as well. I mean, the other guests, they can chat and do whatever, but they gotta put it back in the same spot. So it's up to the sniper to keep track of them. No light highlighting. And same thing for this. And then you bang. There's a little alcove here because I wanted to extend it and put that in there. And basically, that's just, I changed the path a little bit. Anyways, come up here. This is kind of the spawn point, so I modified it, putting all the different rules and things like that. A new idea for the contact the double agent. You have to get in conversation and show him a piece of paper. So whatever the piece of paper is, there it is. So basically, you might want to keep that aside, and then when you show it to him, you gotta quickly flash it while being in the same conversation as him, and then the DA will type in the banana bread instead of you, Irene. Because if you type in, people are gonna know who you are, right? But the sniper will have the idea there's two double agents. But once the double agent utters it, then he'll know which one it is real. Also, I've taken out the flip thing and just made it more easier for the sniper because point of view is a little farther. As you can see, he starts over here and then he takes his one bullet and one arrow. All the guests will, so he better shoot just in case there's more. But if he actually misses and doesn't hit anybody, he has to come all the way over here and get more arrows that way. Anyways, yeah, this is kind of the platform I've built for him. Conversations have four slots, so there can only be four people in conversation. You stand like this, point facing the center, and you're in crouch mode to converse. Right now the avatars are a little buggy, something's wrong with the avatars, but you can, and this is how you talk. This is when you're chatting up conversation. There are also a rule: when Toby gives you a drink, you must hold it. And the way the drink works is that you gotta go 1, 2, and then 3, finish it. You can as long as you want, but as long as it doesn't go away. You gotta basically fake drink it twice and fully drink it 3 times. And once you're done, it's not emptying, but let's say it's empty, I just toss it back to the Toby. Or he'll be handing out the drinks, Minecraft style. So yeah, I have the character selection here, all these different icons, up to 10. So we have 3 guests here, 3 guests here, and 4 guests here. And the moderator or whatever is going to be doing, he'll just, instead of saying who the spy is so the sniper doesn't hear, he'll just place a red torch in front of that person, and that's who's going to be the spy for that round. Yeah, this is the sniper's position. We also have the veranda map, which I've accommodated for it as well. Same kind of thing. I put the books in the bookcase. You got that. I moved the chat circles and I turned them off because I hope you don't mind the subtle changes. And I took out, as you can see, the tower. There's no need for the NPC since we're going to have our own Daemon security guard. I don't know why would anyone want to play him, but he's there just in case. You don't really need him. So a whole lot of redstone. The balcony map, I've made this a little smaller, but it's not done yet because we don't have a seduction yet. So I'll have to work out the kinks of that. Any ideas, go ahead. So I put this little sign here, not available to play yet. And yeah, this is the thing. There you go. So yeah, when you want to switch it, the spy obviously will start with one of these. I mean, yeah. And then he'll come up, an NPC can grab it. See, he grabbed it. He cannot walk away with it. and he just inspects it. He can go ooh, crouch, and ooh, ah, up and down. He cannot move, and then place it back down. If you're a spy, he has to replace it with a different one, and there's only two of a kind, like I said before. Oops. Yeah, these are the windows. If you want to add time, I did actually, because we will be keeping time. The moderator will be keeping time. And he can go up to the window and punch. Just punch, and time will be added. I haven't worked out the kinks, maybe not. Maybe time adding will be set. We will have near a time limit, so I'm thinking of importing actually a giant clock to put it in here and for the spy to see, and for the sniper to see. There are clocks out there, so I might do that, like a giant redstone clock. Anyways, just a short little video. It's not HD or anything, just showing you guys how the play is gonna happen, and yeah, thanks for watching.